This video is going to be an introduction to set builder notation. So there are basically two ways to write a set. One way is just to list all of the elements of the set inside curly braces. So if I have a set with just the four elements, 1, 2, 3, 4, I can write capital A, we'll call this set A, capital A equals, and then inside curly braces, 1, 2, 3, and 4, separated by commas. If I want to have all the numbers starting at 1, all the natural numbers, and continuing infinitely, I could write three dots, what we call an ellipsis, and that would mean I start at 1 and I just count, well, if I could, up to infinity. The other way to write this would be in set builder notation. So what I'm going to do is write something like this. I'll put in the capital A, that's the name of the set, put in my equal sign, the left curly brace, and then I'm going to pick a letter. Very often the letter is going to be a lowercase x, but actually it could be any letter you want. Typically lowercase though, so we're not confusing it with another set. And then I'm going to put a bar. And after the bar, what I'm going to do is describe what x could be. And I want to say that x could be any natural number, or x is all natural numbers. So I could write all natural numbers, but since mathematics is more universal than just a single language, mathematicians would rather write in symbols. So what we're going to do is put in x and then the element sign, that kind of elongated E, and a capital N for set N, and curly braces, the right curly brace. And I can read this as follows. A equals the set of all x such that, such that x is an element of N, meaning x is a natural number. Okay? Now, if I wanted to, I could take my set, the 1, 2, 3, 4, and the ellipsis, and say, I'm just going to go up to, 53. That's all the numbers I want in my set. What that means is, I've got to add something to my set builder description. I've got to not only say that x is a natural number, x is an element of n, I've also got to say that x is one of the numbers, or is all of the numbers, from 1 to 53. So I'll do that by writing, after the n, I'll put in a comma. The comma, in this case, means and. And then I'm going to put 1 is less than or equal to x is less than or equal to 53. So that will take care of all the numbers from 1 to 53. And the fact that they're natural numbers means I'm not getting any fractions or decimals. And then I'll just finish off with the right curly brace. And I'll read this as A equals the set of all x such that x is an element of set N and 1 is less than or equal to x is less than or equal to 53. Okay, so let's try a slightly more complicated example. Here I've got set B, and set B is even numbers, 2, 4, 6, 8, and then my ellipsis, which means I'm going to keep going with even numbers. So I want to do this in set builder notation. Well, I'll start out with my capital B for the name of the set equals the curly brace. I'm going to use the x again and a bar. So B is the set of all x such that, and now I run into a bit of a problem because I want to say that x is only even numbers, but I don't want to use words. So what I'm going to do is this. I'm going to say that instead of saying x, I'm going to say it's the set of all 2x. Now here's how this works. It's the set of all 2x such that, that's my bar, x is an element of the natural numbers. X is an element of set N. So what's happening is this. I'm thinking of all the natural numbers, 1, 2, 3, 4, but my set elements are going to be 2x. So I'm going to take each of the natural numbers and multiply by 2, which will give me all of the even numbers. And as before, if I wanted this set to stop somewhere, let's say I wanted to stop at 200. I want 2, 4, 6, 8, up to 200. Then I'm going to have to modify my set builder version. Besides saying that x is an element of set n, I have to put in a comma, and I want x to be not between 2 and 200. I want half of that. I want x to be between 1 and 100. Here's why. So 1 is less than or equal to x is less than or equal to 100. And now when I take the numbers from 1 to 100 and I double them, I'll get the numbers, the even numbers, from 2 to 200. Okay? Here's one more. A little trickier, but maybe not that hard. So I've got set D, and set D is the numbers 1, 4, 9, 16, and so on, the ellipsis. And if you look at these numbers, you realize these are all perfect squares, starting with 1 squared and 2 squared and 3 squared and 4 squared. Now the fact that these are squares is going to be a hint as to how I write the set builder notation. I'm going to say that set D equals the set of all x squared such that x is an element of set n. So when I do that, I'll have all the natural numbers, but the elements of set D are going to be the squares of those numbers. That's why I've written x squared. And again, if I only want to go up to, I don't know, let's say 100, then besides saying x is an element of set n, I'm also going to say that x is, or 1, is less than or equal to x and is less than or equal to 10, because 10 squared will get me to 100. Okay, so that's the basic idea behind set builder notation. You can get very fancy with this. You can sometimes find alternative ways of doing it, but the general principles are the ones I've laid out. Okay, that's about it. I'll see you next time.